The state attorney general has opened an investigation into the relationship between Governor Katie Hobbs and a group home provider that donated to the governor's inauguration committee and state Democratic Party. And for more on this, we welcome the Arizona Republic's Stacey Barchenger. Her reporting led to the AG's investigation. Congratulations on that reporting. Great job there. Thanks for joining us and helping us figure out what's going on here. Again, attorney general opens, this is a criminal probe, correct?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay, give us the wherefores and whatnots here.
Okay, so this, we reported this story about this new political spending campaign launched by this group home last week. Republican Senator T.J. Shope asked both Attorney General Mays and Maricopa County Attorney Rachel Mitchell to launch an investigation. He suggested crimes like fraud, bribery, contract violations. Mays said almost immediately she would look into it. I believe Mitchell is also going to investigate as well.
Yes, and we want to get to Mitchell in a second here, the county attorney, but the idea is what? That this is a group home provider, a state contractor that provided what gave money to the... Well, this inauguration fund just never goes away, does it?
Yeah, it's quite interesting. We were talking about this a year and a half ago, right? This is a... So the Department of Child Safety contracts with homes that shelter kids who they don't have a foster family for or can't, you know, get adopted. There's dozens of these providers. This one, Sunshine Residential Homes, had no donation history, no political donation history in the decade before they started giving to the governor and her party in 2022 and 2023. About the same time, they get what amounts to a 60% increase in the daily pay that they get from the state.
Indeed. And this again, these are kids, as you mentioned, taken from parents, put into state homes here. Were they, and they were the only group home given this kind of increase in pay?
Yeah, so there's the way that DCS talks about this, there's sort of two ways that they pay these providers. There's obviously the contract negotiation process, so people get their nightly rates or their daily rates set then, but then providers go to the department and they ask for more money, separate from the contract negotiation process, right? We're all feeling inflation, and that is true for them as well.
Right.
And so, yeah, in Governor Hobbs, what are we at now? 18 months in office, there have been about a dozen requests, and only one of those was approved, and it was for Sunshine Residential Homes.
And it results in Sunshine getting the highest daily rate for daily average rate for a child. Is that true?
Yeah, that was the result of the contract process that just finished in April and May of this year.
Okay, back to the inauguration fund. I thought the AG kind of looked into that in the past. Was that not done? Was this missed? What was going on?
No, so that was a little bit different. Representative David Livingston, a Republican from Peoria, asked Mays to look into whether the governor used state resources, that being the state website, to fundraise for the inauguration, prompted a whole debate in the legislature about whether the inauguration is a public event, whether it's a private one. Governor Hobbs created this dark money group that they revealed the donors to once and never again. So what Mays ultimately determined is, you know, Governor Hobbs did this much like governors before her, named Governor Ducey specifically, and that there was no violation of this law that says you can't use the state resource for a political activity.
But now she's looking at the fund in part here again, and she wants to look at this on her own. She wants her office to look at it on their own. And you mentioned Rachel Mitchell, Maricopa County attorney, along with what the Auditor General. They're saying, we want to look at it too, huh?
Yeah. Surprising number of people wanted to look into this after we published the story. You know, Mays made the argument that to have two different agencies investigating the same thing is a waste of resources. You know, who knows what that means if conclusions are different, but wanted sole authority to look into this. And then we just found out, you know, Rachel Mitchell said yesterday that she would work with the Auditor General on their own investigation to scrutinize this.
Is that unusual to have two different agencies like that going at the same thing?
I understand it to be fairly unusual, though I did a clip search of our archives, and I guess it did happen back in the 90s. A couple of aides to Governor Symington were investigated, although I'm not sure the investigations were at the same time. It was one right after another.
What about the idea that the Attorney General needs to recuse herself because this Sunshine Homes they gave to the Democratic Party, and she's part of the Democratic Party?
Yeah, I am certain you will hear Republican lawmakers talk a lot about that, whether Chris Mayes can conduct a fair and impartial investigation, because it's her party. There is, separately from this, this panel of House Republicans that thinks she should be impeached because they think she's selectively enforcing laws. So there's a lot of distrust with her and this investigation. But Mays's office says they've taken steps to make sure that the public can have faith and confidence in their probe. The attorney general represents DCS, so yes. They've built a firewall, and DCS will hire their own lawyers for whatever this investigation turns out.
Oh, sounds awfully complicated here. Governor's response to all this?
Prior to publication, they said the governor's office had no role in DCS setting rates for Sunshine residential homes. Subsequently, this week we were able to ask her directly about this for the first time, and she says she has no comment, but she would never do something that wasn't in the best interest of Arizona children. She's a social worker.
Interesting. Okay. Before you go, now that we got you here, I know that the budgets, that things are bubbling down there.
Yeah.
I know that there's some sort of draft plan making the rounds. We've seen copies of it. Apparently, it's a really rough draft here. What's it say? What's the budget looking like right now?
Yeah, the predictions are coming to reality here. It's a cuts budget, right? Looking at like $16 billion for the next fiscal year, over $1 billion in cuts. That's cutting back road projects that they funded last year. A couple of Governor Ducey's priorities on water are not making it into the final draft as far as we know now.
Yeah, that Water Infrastructure Finance Authority deal, that thing's the third year of it or something is pretty much gutted, huh?
Yep, exactly. And this is, this is what they did last year. They took some of this money. I guess this is the peril of making funding commitments 3 years out. You never know what's going to happen
exactly.
In the third year.
Exactly. But these agency fund transfers and these sorts of things, we have to remember, this is stuff that the governor's office has negotiated.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely. So it's a lot of moving money around from agencies and various funds. And then there's a roughly 3.5% cut from all state agencies. Not all, most.
Yes.
There are some exceptions, like the Department of Public Safety. And to be determined when we get more budget documents, what that actually means. Is it staff? Is it office supplies? How do you make up those numbers? We don't quite know yet.
What about ESAs? Everyone wants to know. Is ESAs, is the third rail been touched?
There's something that I think we will see the governor talk about. There is a guardrail on ESAs. It's about a $2.5 million savings in apparently kids who are in public schools can qualify for ESAs in the summer. Sort of this double dipping situation, so they eliminate that.
$2.5 million.
Yep, in the $16 billion budget.
And ESAs are what? There's 400, there's hundreds of millions of dollars. $2.5 million, and yet can the governor say, look what I did. Can she consider that a success and a win?
I absolutely think she will consider it a success and make her pitch. I think you'll also see Republicans note that that was all she got.
Yeah, yeah. And again, as far are the votes here for this rough draft? I mean, are they wrangling them up as we speak? What's going on?
They're doing that as we speak. I ran into House Speaker Ben Thoma this morning, asked him about that. He said, we're not really sure if they're ready. Technical changes, consulting with the caucus, to be determined.
But determined relatively quick. You got to get by June 30th, don't
yeah.
you?
It's
a done deal by June 30th.
Yeah, but, these are lawmakers that meet until 4 a.m. to get the budget done. So
yes.
2 weeks is a long time.
Well, great job again reporting on all of this. And thank you so much for sharing the reporting with us. We really appreciate it. Stacey, thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you for having me.